People think pigeons are dirty, so I took pigeon DNA and spliced it together with parrot DNA in our home laboratory. We fertilized eggs and put them in their incubators for many weeks until they began to hatch. And when they were born, we created the parrot pigeon. They look like pigeons, but are colorful like parrots. We let them go in some of the surrounding cities to see how they interacted with the other pigeons, and they fit in perfectly. We kept one of them for our own and let the rest go back into the cities where they belong. Thanks. This experiment started off by taking DNA from my pet owl and splicing it together with DNA from one of my pet parrots. I took their samples to my laboratory where I spliced them together in fertilized eggs, and after a few months, they were born. These are the world's first half parrot, half owl. I call them Powls. They're extremely friendly creatures, and they're beautiful. I made about 700 of them and let many of them go back into the wild. What kind of animals would you like to see next? This new animal species started off by taking DNA from a horse and splicing it with DNA from our pet rabbit in our home laboratory. This process did not take very long, until we fertilized eggs and set them in their incubators, where they stayed for 5 months until they hatched. What you are about to see is the world's first half horse, half rabbit. We bottle fed them until they were old enough to be on their own and eat solid foods. You can notice their hooves and their horse-like face with their rabbit body. They're amazing creatures. This experiment started off by taking DNA from our pet seal and splicing it together with DNA from our pet cat in our home laboratory. After splicing eggs, it only took about 2 months for them to hatch. We bottle fed these amazing new creatures until they were old enough to eat on their own. What you are looking at is the world's first half cat, half seal animal hybrid. I made these initially for my wife as she wanted something playful as a pet, but we made quite a few and so we sold some of them. Here's a happy customer who bought one. This is my second attempt of trying to create an Easter bunny, and like the first, I started with DNA from my personal chickens. I then took the DNA from our family pet bunny. He is so cute and lovable. The DNA was taken to my laboratory where we fertilized eggs. And although it didn't come out as I expected, it did come out amazing. My Easter bunny is more like a chicken than a bunny, but he looks like a bunny. As you can see, he has bunny-like fur instead of feathers, and he hobbles around like a bunny. Although this isn't what I expected and what I wanted, I'm one step closer to creating a real Easter bunny.